This is Dylan, aka Xenomos, and this is my final product for the Marvel Tramsay 2018 auction. As you can see, it's a Sam Bucky drawing, and I had a lot of fun doing it. This was my first time participating in a fandom auction, even though I've seen a lot of them going around since I joined fandom, but I never had the skill or the confidence or the time to participate in one, so I was very happy that this time I finally could do it. And it also helped that there wasn't an hard timeline and a deadline very close, but we had almost a year to finish our piece, and this helped so I could organize my time better. And of course, the mods were also very helpful. Since it was my first time, I had a lot of questions, but the website is very well organized, and also there is a lot of communication, so if you have any doubt, you can ask or look for the answer on their website or Tumblr, which I will link in the description. And so when I had doubt about how to organize my offered list, they helped a lot. And so I had some difficulties choosing what to offer, because Marvel is such a huge property and there is so much you can offer. But in the end I picked a couple of ships and some characters that I liked the most, and I was very lucky and very happy that I was bidded upon. And bidding week was very exciting, because I was always checking if someone had bid on me, and when it finally happened I was so flattered and so happy that someone decided to trust me, because I'm not a big name in fandom and there isn't a lot of Marvel art that I've done around the internet, so it was a bit of a leap of faith to choose to pick me, and I really much appreciated. And I was very happy with how it went on, and it was such a beautiful experience. I was really happy and lucky to have such an opportunity. Anyway, this was a great auction, not just for me, but also because the total amount donated last year was over 19,000, and the most donated two charities were Planned Parenthood, the Trevor Project, and International Refugee Assistance Project. Of course, as the name says, it's all charities and organizations that probably Trump supporters would hate, so I was also very happy, because most of these charities are projects I personally support, and I think it's right to support them. Anyway, we could also choose some preferred charities, and I was lucky enough that my bidder was very kind and decided to pick one of them, and so my bidder personally bidded and donated to Rainbow Railroad, which is an organization that helps queer people escape violence in their own countries. Anyway, Marvel Tramsay will return in 2019, and the moderators have confirmed that this year there will be another edition, and I'm very happy about it. And I'm not sure I will participate, since I've seen there's also fandom Tramsay, and I don't really draw Marvel things a lot, but I really like the option to have different fandoms, maybe some less known fandoms for which it's hard to find or commission art, so that people will know that I'm available, since I don't do commission at the moment, but so they can bid and have fan art for some different fandoms, since Marvel is a very big fandom and there is a lot of choice. So I have to see if Phantom Thread 8 will have another edition, and also if I will have the time to participate in Marvel Thread 8. Of course, I think I will offer pretty much the same things as last year, since not a lot of has changed for me regarding content, but we'll see. I mean, there is still a lot of time to decide, and I will leave all the links in the description in case you are interested. Last year, and so probably next year too, and this year, I was also offering not safe for work drawings, but in the end, my bidder chose a safe for work drawing because she told me she wanted to use it as a phone background, and this was quite lucky because so I can record it and put it on YouTube, which I couldn't have if I had gone with something kinkier. So this turned out quite well. I hope my bidder was happy with what she got, and she got the tire for line art only, and I think despite this being only a line art, with this inking style I tried to do a very finished piece, and I hope she liked it. And especially adding the textures and the black flats in the end, even though I forgot to record it, I think they made the piece look more finished, and I really liked it better that way. And anyway, there was a lot of back and forth between us because she chose what she wanted, and then I told, and then I sent her the pose and then the sketch, and then she had to tell me if I was going in the right direction, and it all went smoothly, and I'm very thankful. She was very patient with me, and I hope I was able to do something that she liked. I mean, she seemed quite happy with it, so I'm happy about that. And she chose to have Bucky in the Black Panther post-credit scene clothes, aka his White Wolf attire, while she wanted Sam in these traditional African clothes called dashiki. And it was very nice to draw these clothes because I like Bucky's Wakandan outfit, and I think it's really good, especially with the texture in the end. And also the pattern on the dashiki was very fun to draw, and so it was a very relaxing sort of repetitive action, but I could really chill and relax while I was doing this. And so I really had fun with it. My favorite part is probably Bucky's drapery on his clothes, because it looks very elegant. Both of their clothes look very elegant, and so it was nice to draw them in this, and I'm happy with what my bidder chose. Of course, I had to use a lot of references, both for the clothes and for their faces, as you can see in the beginning. I keep my photos in the same file so I can see them really side to side and check for mistakes. And I did so for the clothes too in the sketching process, and I didn't need them anymore once I was inking, so you can see better what I'm doing. And the inking process went quite smoothly. I think I followed the references pretty good, and the dress turned out quite good, and their faces too, and Sebastian Stan looked a bit weird, but then I added the beard in the end, and it suddenly seemed alright, so that went really well. Lucky me. And I really like Sam and Bucky's relationship, and I think it was really cute to have them in this public display of affection. And I don't know, maybe they are just walking around in Wakanda and there's no one around, and Sam is feeling a little bit silly, and so he uses the moment to surprise Bucky with a kiss. I don't know, I just think it's very cute, and that it was a really nice prompt. When I posted this on Tumblr, they told me that it was the first feel that I had Sam Bucky as a pairing, so I'm also happy to represent them in the auction. And I hope that next year, or in the next years, we will have more of this pairing, since there's the TV series scheduled to go on air, for which I'm quite excited. I'm really curious about what they are going to do and what stories they will choose to tell, because since Sam is now captain, I would like to see more of their interactions in this universe, but also maybe some episodes in the past, and to flesh out their histories, maybe with some flashbacks, since they were a bit sidelined in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Since now we have seen a bit of them in Civil War, but and also in the previous Captain America movies, but I think they never really went deep down in what went in their minds. Especially I'm curious about Sam and his past, and there's a lot of stuff that can be told. And also I'm curious about the new costumes. I always had a sweet spot, soft spot for the white and red Falcon costume. I think it was very iconic, but also the Captain America Sam Wilson version of the costume is very good, and so I wish they will make the costumes very colorful, because lately I've noticed that they try to tone it down for the movies and make it more realistic, in a sense that is maybe less colorful and less campy. But I really like colorful costumes, so I hope they decide to do at least some I will call it fan service for the comic, for the comic fans, especially since there is also the What If show. So maybe in the What Ifs we can see some costumes that we have never got to see, and some different storylines or interactions that would be really cool to explore. So I don't think that Sebastian Stan and Anthony Mackie can film both at the same time, so maybe they won't have time to do the What If TV show if they are filming for the Winter Soldier and Falcon TV show. But we'll see. I mean, they are used to do a lot of crossover in Marvel, and I think they can totally manage it, and Disney for sure is very good at doing crossover between their properties, so I think there is still a possibility to see them in both, and I would be quite happy with that. Anyway, we are near the end, and I would like to thank again my bidder and the moderators of Marvel Trump's 8, and everyone for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will leave links in the description box. And have a nice day. Bye!